There's so much to like about Wriddhiman Saha, and as some of you watch these vlogs, you'd realize I like quiet, understated cricketers who just go and do their job and don't talk a lot about it, just let their work speak for itself. And nobody does that more than Wriddhiman Saha does. And yet, if you look at his career, it could well have been a story of what might have been, a story of bad luck. Here you are with the mighty MS Dhoni, and hardly ever gets injured, played on and on and on, and the next thing you know is there's young challengers coming up, and Saha could have been a little footnote in Indian cricket between Dhoni on the one hand and Rishabh Pant on the other. So what do you do in situations like these? If Dhoni is the keeper and your best years are leaving you behind, all you can do is keep on trying, and I think that's what Saha did. He never ever let the purity of his wicket-keeping diminish. And so, when Dhoni finished, you probably didn't get the same personality, but you got a very, very fine wicket-keeper. Then the bad luck started to hit again. A little injury happened during that series in South Africa. Maybe he was carrying it already. It was misdiagnosed. He should never have been playing the IPL. Got even worse during the IPL. And you thought, right, this injury is not only going to finish Saha, it's giving his replacement enough time. His replacement not as much as a keeper, but as a flamboyant attacking batsman. And then MSK Prasad himself, a keeper, said, currently, Rishabh Pant is our number one keeper. And I thought, right, we've seen the end of Saha. And then this Indian policy of horses for courses that throws up unusual results sometimes. And I think they came up with the right decision, saying on Indian wickets, who is the best wicket keeper? And I think there was never any doubt, not just in India, but you can scour the cricket playing world. And in these conditions, you won't find a better keeper than Saha. By the way, it must be mentioned that in the West Indies, when Pant was keeping, in a sense, the person coaching him along, for want of a better word, was actually Saha. And that tells you a lot about the person. But then he came to Vishakhapatnam and I got the feeling he was a little unsure, a little rusty. Remember, you're 34, 35. You don't know how much time you have left in this game. And you're thinking, right, I've got a chance. I've got to make the most of it. Sometimes you can be too eager. By the time he came to Pune, he was ready. And then he took that catch of Tennis De Bruyne. And he's probably on his way back thinking, that happens once. And then it happened again. It happened right in front. I was sitting in the commentary box. I could see him flying away to his left, and it was just magnificent. Then the catch of Faf du Plessis, and that is what you will see in the highlights. What I enjoyed watching about Saha was what you didn't see in the highlights. Just the ease with which the turning, when the ball turned, the ease with which it found its way into his gloves. When it stayed a little low, there he was. When it bounced, there he was. And that is the quality of a great keeper. That's what I like about Saha. Now, there's a suggestion made that he should score more runs, and I agree. Any runs are welcome, especially when you're travelling overseas, where India tend to play six batsmen, four bowlers. The keeper becomes a key ingredient over there. But I've always believed that a keeper must be judged as the sum of two parts, as a sum of the runs that he scores and the runs that he saves. Now, how do you calculate how many runs a keeper saves? You don't just see that in the number of buys saved or leg buys saved by diving, but in the catches that cut short innings in full flow. If the catch had not been taken, how many runs would that batsman have gone and made? If the little stumping had not happened, how many runs would you have lost? So it's very difficult to assess how many runs a keeper saved. But I just think that a keeper should be assessed on those two fronts and in the confidence with which the bowlers run into bowl. On a varying track, there's Jadeja, who's difficult to keep. There's Ashwin, who's experimenting all the time. They must feel confident about their keeper. And I think Saha allows them that benefit. So I'm absolutely delighted for him. My favorite Saha performance is still from the SSC in Sri Lanka in 2017. I've told this story before, but we almost gave him man of the match. 116 overs on a turning track, and he did not concede a bye. If it does spin violently in Ranchi, then I think we've got the best man behind the stumps. I'm overjoyed for Wriddhiman Saha. I hope he has longish innings. But if this is the innings that he's going to have, then he's already had a good one.